half an hour after BBC Two Wales plots a remarkable rise to chart success.
The former manager of pop act Blue, Daniel Glatman, recently found his new boy band when at a friend's wedding in North Wales, the Fron Male Voice Choir. After signing a record deal with Universal, the 60-strong group of middle-aged part-timers from the Welsh town of Roncesvalles has risen from obscurity to the top of the classical music charts. Their album, Voices of the Valley, has become the fastest-selling classical album of all time. This is their story so far.
Where do we start? Where do we start? Well, we sang at a wedding just down the valley, and in the audience was a chap called Daniel Glatman.
Here was the Voices of the Valley, and there was an amazing passion. We have to get this act into a recording studio. We have to get that sound on record.
Who obviously heard something that he liked, and phone calls led to meetings, led to further on from there. He came along and heard rehearsals, and he said he was going to try and seek out a recording contract for us, which we took with a pinch of salt. And then he was true to his word. He's worked really hard on our behalf, and he phoned back one afternoon and said, I've got a recording contract in my hand for three albums with Universal.
Well, you're in Roncesvalles now, and you're alongside the Zion Chapel where the Vaughan Choir started way back in 1947. I think some of the other founder members are in here waiting for us, so I'll introduce you to them.
I think the young people will be looking at today's charts and seeing this odd name kind of thing, a male voice choir at the top end of the charts kind of thing. And I think they may be attracted, and I hope that they will be attracted to it. I think it will have an effect, just like ballroom dancing.
But put it this way, we joined at 16 and we've had a wonderful time.
Yeah, marvellous.
You know, it's 60 years next year.
Everybody knows everybody, and we all go for a drink after and have a sing-song.
We go to practice, and we practice hard. We tour the world, so it really is a good life.
You really would make me very, very happy, and my Christmas would be lovely if you went tyred o seren in calon I ti a this day, if you kept going. I've asked for it many times. It's like writing a letter to Santa. Yeah. Please, Santa. Right, let's have a little go again, please, just to keep going over these words. Okay.
This is the main prison yard, where I come to work every morning and have done for the last 30 years. You walk this way. In the days of
hanging in prison. Condemned man would have been kept in here until his day of execution. Moving along now. We have a new song, and I do nights regular. I very often write the words down, big fashion. And I find myself walking along, reciting the words, and you come past a door, and somebody will kick the door and say, I'm trying to get to sleep here. So you quickly put the song away rather than have a riot in your hands. I'm the celebrity screw.
We've got about 650 pupils. That includes a sixth form. We're 11 to 18. Yes, this is them. This is my GCSE IT class. You can go to the choir, you're singing out, you're giving everything to the music. You forget about everything else, all your worries have gone. You're just concentrating on that music. And it is really a good stress buster. Right, can we start logging off, please?
What do you have?
Sit down, just log off.
I'm logged off.
Danny, don't put your coat on. Ear tech, can I have you all sitting down, please?
Well, I was always, I was in a member of the church choir from the age of 9, and then I came 15 and my brother Dennis said, what about joining the male voice? So there was four of us, we all joined together in 1954. And when you see yourself on television, it's you pinch yourself really, you know, is it real? After 60 years all this is happening, it's just, you know, that is the fact. It's unbelievable. I don't think it'll affect me at all.
I'm in with the in crowd. I go where the in crowd goes. I'm in with the in crowd. And I know what the in crowd knows.
You were treated, oh, so was I tonight.
Wow, I was
very lucky.
Dressing fine, making time. We breeze up.
Well, when they hit the charts at the time, I was down in Torquay on a 4-day break. And I bought their CD down there. And they'd sold out, there was only two left on the shelf. So that was absolutely wonderful.
I rushed to the first shop to buy the CD.
Did you? But mine's special.
And I got it signed by...
Because they've signed mine.
And he signed mine.
No,
as well.
I got more signatures than yours.
Daniel signed mine. And Jacko.
Oh, mine's definitely better.
Well, you got more signatures, have you?
Of course I have.
Oh, well. I've only got the two.
I was at my friend Solomon and Penny's wedding in at a place called Trevor Hall in North Wales, and this amazing noise suddenly started to come from these chaps that were standing at the front. This noise suddenly resonated off this beautiful scenery, the Vale of Llangollen. Literally hit me right in the heart, and I thought, we have to get this sound on record. I always thought this record, if we did it properly, the sound would connect with people. There's just so many things about this story that just keeps getting better and better and better. And to be involved with such a record is a real honour and a privilege.
I didn't know that they were singing tonight. We just bought tickets. I'd bought the CD in the week, and then I was just blown away when, you know, we found out it was the choir here tonight.
Okay, can you sing that patch for me together? So that's second tenors and first bass, and that's everybody. Actually, you're all on a D flat. Have yourself. What time is it?
I came last year. I liked it so much I came back this year.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. Of sight.
I think it's very good and they're very good choir.
Oh yeah. Is it strange?
No.
Oh, there you go.
Absolutely marvellous.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I wish you a very warm welcome indeed to St Francis Church. To those of you who came to last year's Gala Christmas concert will know just how lucky we are to welcome back the Grand Male Voice Choir.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, can I have your attention, please? I got some excellent news for the Bron Choir. Voices of the Valley sold 80,000 this week.
Hey! Voices of the Valley has now sold 180,000 copies in 3 weeks.
Where's Eric?
I've been corrected, that's 180,000.
I've just seen somebody buying one in
Towsers.
181,000.
We sold 180,000 and one.
Voices of the Valley will sell 500,000 records before the end of this year.
You've been offered a concert tour in the UK by a guy by the name of Simon Rann. He's probably one of the biggest concert promoters in the United Kingdom. I put it to your committee. They're aware of this. They're going to pontificate it or whatever, discuss it tomorrow night. Congratulations on getting a tour offer. If you do decide to green light this, which I hope you will do because it is an amazing offer, you should really give it 100% and put on something that will give a very true and excellent representation of what it is you will do. So congratulations, and I await your decision from the committee. Thank you. Cheers.
Thank you, Daniel.
Complications arise because I would say a third of the choir are working full-time. A third of the choir are sort of part-time workers and the rest are retired. So the retired guys, it's no problem. I mean, there's a subtle balance within the choir that some members, that they join the choir of their own free will because they enjoy singing, but you can only push them so far with activities. And then they sort of back off and say, wow, that's too much, isn't it, you know? Unbelievable. This is what you call dedication. At the moment we're on the crest of a wave, and you're just riding it and hoping that you're going to come out the other side okay. Oh, well done. Well done. Well done, man. Well done. having been around for 60 years as a choir, I think we've got the maturity to go through this, but we will be careful. The one thing that we must do is preserve the Vron choir, so that must be preserved. And we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens.
Basically, gents, we had a committee meeting on Tuesday. The committee discussed it. It was a 9-concert tour, and we felt it was an excellent opportunity for the choir, and we unanimously agreed to proceed with it. So basically what I need tonight now, I need from yourselves a show of hands that you also feel unanimous that we go ahead. Could I have a show of hands, please? I think that's passed unanimously.
What is the major attraction of male voice choirs? You get away with the boys.
Pavarotti!
Hello, Mum.
Be good,
yeah.
I'll try to. When we got here, we was a little bit thirsty, so managed to have a couple of pints and a little bit of a sing-song.
We're assured that the hotel's well equipped for the night.
Yeah.
We're not used to places like this, tall buildings and stuff, so, you know, it's just all new to us.
It was a great trip down to London when all the choir went, which was really lovely. And some of the guys, you know, I suppose one or two of them, haven't been to London that many times.
We're going to walk across the famous zebra crossing.
Well, like you said, it's quite historical, I suppose, doing what the Beatles did.
I should have taken my shoes off like Paul McCartney did, shouldn't I? Yeah.
Well, obviously it's to do with the Beatles, like, but it's music, isn't it? You know, Abbey Road Studios and the music, and that's what I relate it to myself personally, like.
Brilliant. What other words can we actually use? It's been brilliant.
Without the wags, I mean, it's been fantastic.
Well, we're hoping we can go with them, really.
We follow them, and wherever they go, we go. Mm-hmm. Keep them in check.
Because some choirs don't take the wives with them at all. No. So we're very lucky.
We belong to the choir in a sense, of, especially for what we do for them.
We're enjoying all the side effects of it all, really. And it's good for us as wives.
And so the Vron advertising for a musical director. Quite funny, really, because it was advertised as the Vron Male, as in M-A-I-L, voice choir. So I imagine them all with sacks of post. But there we go, I don't think they had that. And I had to tell them that I was a singer myself and that it would be possible that I had to go away and do some singing at times. They seemed quite happy with that. Came to take a rehearsal and thought, well, I shall make them work fairly hard, put them through their paces and they won't want me. But it worked the other way, actually. They said, they came running after me straight away saying, oh yes, we like you very much, we'd like you to take over. And I said, okay, I'll stay, and I'll stay for 6 months and just see how it goes. And it's nearly 5 years now.
How she puts up with us sometimes, like, makes me wonder, but we're very, very lucky to have Anna as our musical director.
It was it, and so was it.
And she can wind us around this, and we go for that.
And away we run, Tom, Tom, the clever son, stole a pig, and away we run.
She's Welsh, you know, through and through.
He stole a pig. stole a pig. Tom, 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 he stole a pig.
Sometimes I'll go straight from work, even dressed like this. I'll pull up in the JCB, I'll pull up in the van at the school.
Pig was eating Tom, was eating Tom with Dolly. Pig was son, pig was son.
When you come out of there at 9 o'clock, you feel like you've been in a sauna and had a full massage. You feel full of it again.
I love performing, you know, and you get a buzz from, you know, coming off stage and the audience and it, and they're giving the standing ovation.
Roche is our main sort of local competitor.
Without any doubt, we are the best choir.
But I'm not totally convinced that all choirs will be taking up the challenge that we took.
Could have happened to us, it could have happened to another choir. It happened to Vron.
We hate the Vron, Vron hates us.
I think you can put it like football teams. Yeah. Just the same as football teams.
I hope that you know, people don't feel too green about it. I'm sure perhaps there are some who do.
If they'd have approached us, then more than likely we'd have agreed, and possibly we'd been going down the same road as Vron.
I do believe he went round the choirs, Tom, and to the rehearsal room and listening to them in concert.
Yes, I wouldn't be a bit surprised.
When it comes to competition, then it's a totally different kettle of fish.
You did, didn't you? Yeah.
But if you remember, we presented this act and this album at the annual Universal Sales Conference alongside U2, Take That, The Killers, Snow Patrol, Razor Light, Catherine Jenkins. And actually the one act that people came away talking about was the Vron Male Voice Choir.
Who are you two?
Voices of the Valley from the Vron Male Voice Choir has gone on to be the fastest selling classical album of all time, outselling the three tenors, Catherine Jenkins, Pavarotti, Nigel Kennedy, you name it, they've done it.
Well, I guess basically for 60 years we've just been an amateur choir. And I think we can only take so much. It should be very, very difficult, I think.
30 seconds.
We really don't know how we are going to really cope. You know, we're looking forward to it, but... There is, I suppose, a limit at the end of the day that amateur people like ourselves, how we can handle it, you know.
I know I've come out of retirement for one night only. I suppose with all this immediate success we've had lately, I suppose I can call myself the oldest boy compared to the oldest boy band in the world.